Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2028, replacing many VLOOKUPs with one match. Click that I in the top right-hand corner to get to the playlist. I'll be podcasting this entire book. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, it's a classic problem. We have to do VLOOKUP once for every month, right? And you can be incredibly careful here about pressing F4 one, two, three times to lock that down to the column, and then pressing F4 once to lock down the whole row. But when you get to this point, the comma, two, comma, false, that two is hard-coded. And as you copy that across, you're going to have to edit the two to a three, right? Now, one inefficient way to do this, a way that I don't like, is to use the column of B1. Column of B1 is, of course, two. But as you copy that across, see, it'll change to the column of C1, which is 3. But think about this. This is constantly figuring out the column number over and over and over again. So what I see people do, and what I prefer more than the columns, is we'll control drag that, put the numbers 2 through 13 up there in a helper cell, and then when we get to this point, we go up and specify that column number, press F4 one, two times to lock it down to the row, comma, false, and so on. But even with that method, VLOOKUP is incredibly inefficient because it has to go search through all of these items here until it finds A308, and that's to figure out B4. When it then moves over to C4, it forgets that it just went and looked, and it starts all over again. All right, so you have one of the slowest functions in all of Excel, the VLOOKUP, comma, false, being done over and over and over for the same item. So here's the much, much faster way to go. We're going to insert a helper column, and this helper column, I call it where, as in where the heck is A308? We'll use a match, equal match. Look for A308 in the first row of the table, press F4 there, comma, 0 for an exact match. All right, and it tells us that, hey, look at that, it's in row 6, how awesome is that? But as we copy down, you see it's in different places all the time. All right, now this match takes as long as the January VLOOKUP takes. They're dead even. But here's the amazing thing. From there, we never have to do a VLOOKUP for the rest of the row. We can just do equal index. Index says, here's an array of answers. I'm going to go to the January cells. I'm going to very carefully here press F4 one, two times. So I lock it down to 4 and 227, but the queue is allowed to change as I move, comma. And then they want to know what row. Well, that's going to be the answer in B4. I'll press F4 one, two, three times to get the dollar sign before the B. All right, copy that across. This formula, these index formulas will happen, these 12 will happen in less than the time it would take to do the February VLOOKUP. All right, if we put Charles Williams timer on this, this whole thing will calculate in about 14% of the time of 12 VLOOKUPs. Your manager doesn't want to see the where, fine, just hide that column. Everything keeps working, right? This is a beautiful way to speed up the 12 months or the 52 weeks of VLOOKUPs. All right, this tip and so many more tips are in this book. Click the I on the top right hand corner there. You can buy the book, 10 bucks ebook, 25 bucks for the print book. All right, so today we had a problem where we had to do 12 columns of VLOOKUP. You can carefully put the dollar signs in, but that third argument still has to be hard-coded. You could use column of B2. I'm not a fan of that because there's hundreds of rows times 12 columns, where it's calculating that over and over. Just use a helper cell in a row, put the numbers 2 through 12, and point to that. It's still inefficient, though, because VLOOKUP, after it figures out January, it has to start back at the beginning for February. So I recommend adding a column with a heading of where and doing a single match there. That match takes as long as the VLOOKUP for January, but then the 12 index functions will take less time than the VLOOKUP for February, and you've trimmed a whole bunch of time. Again, careful with the dollar sign in the index function in both places, one just before the rows and the other one before the columns, a mixed reference in both of them. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.